Celebration of the 200 years of Memphis birth, we present to you the first Black documentary movie detailing 200 years of Black Memphis history. Never in the 200-year history of Memphis has there ever been a Black movie produced by a Black person that tells the Black side of Memphis. I am that person, Anthony F. Elmore, that tells Memphis history. Whitehaven is 99% Black, and white people made Grayson and Elvis Presley the greatest display of white supremacy in the 20th century. Elvis copied his music and style from Black people, yet they do not include Black history at Grayson. In this movie, we tell the Black side of Elvis. White people use Elvis Presley to promote white supremacy, segregation, and racism. White people will cuss me out when I make this next statement. The real Elvis Presley was a Black man by the name of Otis Blackwell, who wrote many of the Elvis Presley early hits.
And this will be Don't Be Cruel, as it was initially written by Mr. Otis Blackwell. Otis, go on over there and do this. Are
you
In 1954, Elvis, as a white man, simply re-recorded this Black man's song. Listen for yourself.
For you, that's all right, no mama.
Well, that's all right, no mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, no mama.
Oh, my love, my darling, I hungered for your touch. Oh.
The true equality for Black people in Memphis was when Blacks in Memphis enlisted in the Union Army in the spring of 1863. By June of 1863, 3,000 men in Memphis and 24,000 in Tennessee had joined the Union Army. In fact, one in every four Black Memphians joined the Union Army. Our Black history in Memphis starts with the Black Union soldiers. Now, let me explain Memphis history. Clearly, the first equality for Black men in Memphis starts with the Union Army. This is what happened in Memphis. White supremacy and racism extricated this Black history from Memphis and Shelby County. The Black soldiers were stationed at Fort Pickering on the river in a Black neighborhood called French Fort. In the 1870s, thousands in Memphis died from the yellow fever. And it was in 1878 when panic set in and 25,000 people fled Memphis in a panic. Those so-called tough and strong Confederate soldiers and the white people ran. They had guns and forced themselves on ships to get out because they feared. In fact, so many white people left that there were 14,000 Black people left and 6,000 whites. Now, it was Robert R. Church who purchased a police wagon, and it was those Black soldiers, the Black militias, who upheld and protected Memphis, Tennessee. In our movie, 200 Years of Black Memphis History, we tell the true story of Memphis. We are premiering the movie on the 200th anniversary of the city of Memphis, Wednesday, May 22nd, 2019, at the Miracle Majestic Theater in Hickory Hill in Memphis. We are arranging a gala premiere, whereas we will have the inclusion of the Black voice in regards to Memphis history. Those of you who cannot attend the movie, do not worry. With us at the theater, we ask you to arrange with friends a movie viewing party concurrently with the film's premiere. You'll be able to join us in solidarity and view the film on YouTube, whereas whatever part of the world you're in, you'll be able to see the movie. Those of you who desire to attend the premiere, tickets are only $10 and can be purchased only from me, Anthony F. Elmore. We have limited seating, and for information about tickets, call me at Anthony F. Elmore Carpets at 452-4330. That number again is 901-452-4330. Or you can email me at Anthony@ElmoreCarpets.com.